Hello, cloggers, and welcome to week 53 of our Clogging at Home videos. First of all, the shirt that I'm wearing today is a polo shirt from our 1999 March Madness workshop. And that year we had a Western theme. So I have a sheriff's badge in the front, and we've got a boot, a cactus, and a cowboy hat in the back. This was the shirt from our Western theme. All right, now, I want to let you know that for starting this week, I'm changing the format just slightly. It's going to be very similar, and I think this is going to work. Part of the reason is I don't have enough time to cue dances from past videos where I've taught things. So there are a lot of great dances that I've taught in past videos that I haven't really had time to do again. So just to give myself a little bit more cueing time each week, I am going to teach only one dance each week, and it will be either intermediate or easy intermediate. If I teach intermediate, then I'll just cue one other intermediate dance. If I teach easy intermediate, then I'll just cue one other easy intermediate dance. But then for the other level, where I don't teach a new dance, I will review the dance that was taught the week before and then cue two more. Because a review always goes quite a bit faster than an initial teach. Okay, I hope this makes sense, and I hope this works for you. And if it doesn't make sense, you can just ignore it, just follow along with the videos anyway. All right, so here we go. Let's get into this week. Last week I taught Sing Me an Old Fashioned Song, Easy Intermediate. It's a dance I wrote with music by Neve Lynn. And so this is gonna be the review of that. Sing Me an Old-Fashioned Song. I'll do a quick walkthrough of everything that we did. I will wait 8 beats. Left foot start with a cross break step. Break, the B-R-A-K-E, put on the brakes. It's not an ankle break type of step. Just double up, step across. By the way, if you want to do an ankle break and lean that right foot over on its side, that's fine, but I'm going to not do it. But there's a pause here, and then a step back, and then with the left, step, rock, step. And that's all it is. Normally a break step is forward, double a step, and step back, and a step, rock a step. Here, we're just crossing it. Double a step, and one, two, three. Leaves your right foot free. We're gonna do a four count vine right. One, two, three, rock step. Let's do those two steps again. One more time, cross break, ready. Go, double step, and one, two, vine right. Now add a brush and turn, go half, face the back, and a double rock two. Gonna do that again, same footwork. Cross break, step, step, one, two, vine right, brush and turn half, and a double rock two. And then add heel slur and a basic to the left and to the right. Heel slur, step, and a basic, heel slur, step, and a basic. And all of that is part A. Part B, there are two versions of part B. Part B1, we're gonna do a clog over loop vine. Double to one, two, three. On four is where you do the loop behind and step, and then continue your vine. Five, six, seven, rock step. Right foot's free, Charleston brush two times. Double to step, touch front, touch back, brush slide. Or with rocking back, if you want, of course. And then clog over loop vine to the right. One, two, three, loop behind. Five, six, seven, rock step. And then there are just four beats here, so we're just gonna do two brushes rather than repeat the Charleston brush. Two brushes, go. Double step, brush slide. Now the second version of part B does repeat the Charleston brushes there because there are 8 beats there instead of 4. So one more time, right foot lead. Let's do 2 Charleston brushes, starting with a right foot, and this will be the second time we get to part B. Ready, go, double step, touch front, brush up. I'm doing it with a rock this time. All right, actually the second and third time that we do part B, it's done like that. You repeat the Charleston brushes. Okay, then we come to the chorus. I guess it's the chorus. Anyway, part C, we're going to do 3 flatlands. You get a little practice on flatlands in this dance. So left foot, double toe, keep your weight on your right, slide as you kick that left foot back, brush up, slide. do that again. So go back, brush, slide. All right, but it happens just once in the step. Then a basic. Let's do it with the right. Double toe, kick it back as you slide, or heel click. Brush up, slide, and then a basic. Let's do three more. Ready, go. Double back, brush up, and a basic. Double back, brush up, and a basic. Double back, brush up, double step, block step. In the dance, we do three, just like that. Leaves your right foot free, and we do one triple stamp with the right. So three double steps, two, three, and then with the left foot, stamp, lift, and heel click or slide with the right. Right foot, one more time, triple stamp, one time. Ready, go, double one, double two, double three, stamp, lift. Okay, after three flat lands and a triple stamp, then we have three toe tappers. Double the step, and then keeping your weight on your left, you're gonna touch in front, slide, double out, slide, touch back. Remember, point your toe down. And repeat with the right, double the step, touch, slide, double the slide, touch, slide. One more time. So once again, it's three of those, just like the flat land, but they're toe tappers this time, and a triple stamp with the right. One, two, three, stamp, lift. And then at the end of the section, we're gonna add a triple brush and a basic. Once again, there's just six beats at the end of this section, so triple brush plus a basic. And that is part C. And then it goes back to part A, then we do the second version of B, we do C, A, second version of B. So it just repeats until we get to the ending. And the ending's just a little different, but it's all steps we've done. Clog over loop, vine left, go. Four, five, six, seven, rock step. Now this time, with the right foot, you're gonna do a heel slur and a basic. Heel slur, step, and a basic. I cue this a heel slur, and you can use your heel if you're secure on your heel, or just a step, slur, step, and a basic. And I recommend the step, slur, step version if you have taps on or if your floor is slick. So once again, but either way, I'll cue it heel slur to basic. Ready, go, and step, slur, step, basic. And the last step is a double stamp lift. So we did a triple stamp lift earlier. Here we're just doing two double steps before the stamp. So double one, double two, stamp, lift. You happen to be lifting the same foot because the triple stamp started with the right, this starts with the left. So you're still gonna lift the left foot. That is the end of the dance. Let's do this ending all together, all three of those steps. Clog over loop vine, then the heel slur basic, and the double stamp. Left foot clog over loop, we're ready. Go, and the one, two, three, four, five, six, heel slur to basic, go right, double stamp lift. And that's it. All right, so we're gonna dance the whole thing. This is called Sing Me an Old-Fashioned Song. I wrote this dance almost 2 years ago, a little less than 2 years ago. Music is by Neve Lynn. She's an Irish singer who does a lot of country songs. Here we go. Get your left foot ready. Weight eight. Start with that cross break. Double step across. Five, six, seven. Cross break. Vine right. Brush and turn half, face to back, double rock two. Cross break, double step, 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 rock nine. Brush and turn half, face front, double rock two. Heel slur the basic. Okay, there she goes. Quad over loop line. Two Charleston brushes. Quad over loop line, right? And then flat land. Go, double back brush. Double back brush up. One more. Triple stamp. Toe tappers. Three times. One more. Triple stamp. Triple brush. And one basic. Cross braid. Vine right. Brush and turn half. Double rock two, cross break, vine right, brush and turn half, double rock two, or fancy double, heel slur, basic, Clog Over New Pine. Charleston Brush Twice. Clog Over New Pine. And we'll do Charleston Brushes at the end here. Flatland three times. One triple stamp. Toe tappers three times. Triple stamp, triple brush, and a basic. Cross braid, vine right, brush and turn half. Double rock two, cross braid, vine right, brush and turn half. Double rock two, heel slur basic, again. Quad over loop vine. Charleston brush twice. Clog over loop vine. Two Charleston brushes. Is the ending. Clog over loop vine again. Heel slur basic to the right. Double stamp lift. And that's Sing Me an Old Fashioned Song. Okay, so I just reviewed one easy intermediate dance. So now I'm going to just cue two easy intermediate dances. One of them is very easy.
Easy intermediate.
In fact, it probably would be considered a beginner two level dance. But the music is kind of quick. The second one has a few intermediate steps in it, so it's a little bit harder, but it's also not as fast. So anyway, first of all, let's do All I Can Do. This dance is a Dolly Parton song called All I Can Do. The sections are fairly simple and they repeat a lot. So as I said, it really comes into the beginner two level dance. But let me just make sure we've got the two steps I want to go over, make sure we know. First of all, we're going to do push-offs left and right, brush and turns, a quarter each, repeat all that. Second part, clog over vine, a triple. And then with the left, you're going to do a stomp double. So remember, that's a triple, but without that first double toe step. So it's and one, and a two, and a three, rock step. With the right foot, do a triple. Left foot, stomp double, pause, stomp double, one, double, two, rock step. All right? So we're going to do a triple and a stomp double together in a row. We'll also do it with the other foot. So let's go ahead and do the left foot lead for a triple. And then you'll do the stomp double with the right. Left foot triple, go. And a one, two, three. Stomp double and right double, left double, right, rock step. And if you have trouble with that combination, just do two triples and it works just as well. The chorus has hillbillies, basics, and over the log. So let's do a quick review of over the log. Two steps forward, one, two. So that takes two beats, so it's and one, and two, and then two quick steps back, and three, and clap on four. Over the log, ready, go, and one, and two, and three, and clap. Sometimes this is done with double toe steps on those first two beats, so that would be and one, and two, and three, four. I think in this dance, I taught it without the double toes, but it can be danced either way. And that's all I want to go over. So we're going to dance All I Can Do. And this is quite fast. I slowed it down. We're going to dance at about 115 beats per minute. All right, so it won't be that super fast tempo. Wait 16 beats, left foot lead. Push off left and right. Oh, and we're going to add claps on those push offs or side rocks. So you clap on the upbeat. So it's double toe step, clap, step, clap, step, and then up and down beat. Clap, clap, right? So do the claps if you want. Here we go. Push off, go. And right. Brush and turn. Twice to face the back. Push off, left and right. Brush and turn twice. Face front, quad over vine. Triple with the right. Stomp double.
stomp double with the right. Push off, again, with the top. Brush and turn twice. Push off, left and right. Brush and turn twice. And that will end it. That's Dolly Parton's All I Can Do, an easy dance I wrote several years ago and used with my classes. And here's another easy intermediate dance. It's almost intermediate. In fact, we used to call this an intermediate dance, but over the years, our levels have gotten a little harder, so this one kind of goes into the easy intermediate level, or it's between easy intermediate and intermediate. Just because it has several intermediate steps. But if you've been dancing through these videos, these are mostly all gonna be familiar. There will be one or two that aren't, however. So quick walkthrough of the things that might be new. First of all, we're gonna do a brush over vine, left and right. I'm not gonna go over that. Brush over vine, go left, go right. Then chug donkey, that's like a donkey, but you start with a single chug first, double step, kick slide, then two touches. Chug donkey. Chug donkey with the right, double step, kick slide, touch across, touch front. And then we have a chug a left turn half, and a double rock two, and you'll repeat all that. That's part A. Part B, triple drag slide. So this may be a little different. Three double those steps, but on the third one, one, two, three. Notice I've got both feet on the floor. So on the third one, keep that left, keep that right foot on the floor as well, because you're going to do a drag slide or a shuffle. Since your knees should be bent at this point, you're going to drag first and then slide. And as you slide, lift that left foot because you need it for the next step. Triple drag slide, left foot. Ready, go, double one, double two, double down, drag, slide, and lift. So think of down on that third double to step, and you'll get it. And then you lift the left, and you do a stomp double, a strum with the right foot, just one strum, double step, cross, out, cross, turning, push off, and then a sideways push to the right. All right, and then we repeat the triple drag slide, stomp double, strum, turning, push off, but instead of a sideways push off, you've got a right foot lead, and we're going to do a thunder step named after the song. It's just a double toe step with another step right away. Do that much. Ready, go. Double step, step, then a pause. Two quick steps, step, step, and one run or double toe step. So that's the right foot, double toe step. Okay, so let's go that slowly again. Right foot, thunder step. It's four beats. Double toe step, step, and step, step, double toe step. Okay, practice that a few times if it's brand new to you. Right foot, one more time, thunder, a little faster. Ready, go, double step, step, and step. So we'll step. Make sure your weight's on your right at the very end. And then we go into the chorus, which is a hillbilly. High horse, quick review, 8 counts, double a step, double a cross slide, double a lap slide, rock step and back, then a toe slide or a toe heel, that'll work, and a double basic. So after that high horse, we have 4 crazy legs. Remember, that's just double a step and back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you do another high horse. Rock step, toe slide, double 1, double 2, rock step. But add a brush slide onto the end. That's something separate, but we're just adding 1 brush slide, and then there's a 1-beat pause. Okay, so let's do that high horse plus the brush, and then you pause a beat before you go into the next step. High horse, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, add a brush, pause, and the next step in the next section is a double whiplash. 2 double steps, side front, and then these 4 weight changes, 1, 2, 3, 4, but that's the simple version. With the slides and drags, it would be slide, step back, drag, step front, slide, step back, drag, step front, and you put a basic on the end. Let's do that double whiplash, left foot, ready, go. Double step, slide, step, drag, step, basic. And then we have a clog over vine right. In that double whiplash, it's the weight changes that are crucial. So if that step's new to you, just do 4 plain steps. 2 double steps first, 4 steps keeping your feet crossed. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that would be and step, and then a basic. Okay, and that simplifies it a lot. And like I said, it's the weight changes that are important. And then the only other thing I want to go over, the very, very end, double whiplash. You're going to do it 3 times. So that means left foot and right foot and left foot. So since you're going to do 3 in a row, that means one of them will be with the right foot. Let's start that one. Do that. Right foot, double whiplash. Go. Double step, slide step, drag step, slide step, drag step. Basic with the left. Go ahead and do 1 more because there will be 3 in a row. Double step, slide step, drag step, basic. That leaves your right foot free for a run, stomp, and pull. This is how I dance this ending. It's just double step, stomp forward a little bit, and then there's a little bit of sound in the music that drags out, so I pull that right toe up just to do something during that, all right? So with the right foot, that's just double step, stomp, pull. Okay, and that's the whole thing. Quick review of Kentucky Thunder. Music by Ricky Skaggs and probably his Kentucky Thunder group. And the dance was written by Carolyn Cook, and this goes back to about 1990. I don't know the exact year, but around about 1990, we were dancing this one. Okay, weight 8. And then you're going to brush over vine to the left and right. Brush over vine. Ready, go. Do it to the right. Brush over. And vine. Chug donkey twice. Chug a leg. Turn half. Double step. Keep turn. Double rock 2. Brush over vine. To the right. Check donkey twice. Check a lot of turn half. Double rock 2. Triple drag side. With the left. Stomp double. 1 strum. Turning push off. Sideways push. Triple drag slide again. Stomp double, 1 strum, turning push left, thunder step, double step, 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 double hillbilly twice, and a high horse, 4 crazy legs back, high horse again, and then add a brush slide to the end and pause, double whiplash. Brush over vine. chug donkeys.
All you take the boy from home, Kentucky.
Chuggle out, turn half, and double rock two and turn face front. Triple drag slide. Strong double. One strum. Turning push off, full turn. Sideways push right. Triple drag slide. Stomp double. Strum. Turning push off. Thunder step. Go Billy. Again. High horse. Four crazy legs. High horse again. And then we're going to add the first slide. And a pause. Double whiplash. Three times. This is the ending. To the right. And again to the left. One round stomp. And sort of pull. Alright. And that's a classic. Kentucky Thunder by Carolyn Cook. Music by Ricky Skaggs. Good one to keep doing. Now here's the intermediate dance I'm going to teach slash review. It's partly a teach, partly a review. I did teach it last week. It's Black Horse in the Cherry Tree, dance by Missy Shinoski, and music by KT Tunstall. But last week I didn't do the optional advanced level steps that are in here. So I'm going to teach two of those today. There is another one, but she didn't go over it in a way I could see tell what she was doing. She just demonstrated it, and I think it includes a pullback, which I don't do, so I'm leaving that one out. But you can watch her video if you want. And her video, she dances this on March 2021 Possum Trot Fun Dance, Virtual Fun Dance. So you can find that online if you want to see her dance that extra step that I won't be doing. But I will show you two others that are advanced, and hopefully I'll do them correctly. But I will review this whole thing because there are several other steps in this dance that will be kind of new. So, although I'll review some of them a little more quickly than last week. So if you didn't do last week's workshop, try it today. If you need a little more work, just go back to week 52 and I spend more time on it, this dance there. But I will concentrate on the parts that have the new steps in it. Okay, Black Horse in a Cherry Tree. We're going to wait just four. She counts it out, or at least the two, three, four. We hear that, so you know when to start. We're going to start with a Shania turn. This is a step slur type of step, and we're going to turn half. It's eight counts. Left foot lead. Step, slur, step, rock, step, slur, step, and then rock, step, forward, slur as you pivot, step. And we're going to do a run toe slide on the end. Double step toe slide to finish it off. Once again, Shania turn. It's one and two and three and four and five. Turn six. Double step toe slide. You're facing the back. You're going to do the same step. Once again, to face front. Ready, go. And step, slur, step. Rock, step, slur, step. Rock, step, slur, turn. Double step toe slide. So two in a row. Later on, one time, there will be one time where we only dance one in a row, and you can either turn all the way around or not turn at all. I usually turn all the way around. I think that's actually easier than not turning at all, because you do that slur forward, and I feel like I want to turn now. Okay, so Shania turn, we do two of those, and that's all there is to part A. One. And then part B, there's several steps in this. Starting with a Kentucky loop, we know that. Double step, drag step, double step, loop behind step. Then a Simone stomp, double one, double two, stomp, stomp, drag, lift. Now here's where, that's where she did a step that I'm not gonna go over. She called it a flap. I can't figure it out from the cue sheet and a little bit of demonstration that she did. I would need more work on it, so I'm not gonna attempt to teach that. And then we go into a Tunstall. This is eight counts. Tunstall for KT Tunstall, of course. So it's a double back and tap back slide, then a scuff up across. Let's do that much. Weight on your right. Double back, tap back, scuff across, then a toe heel across, a tap back again, and a scuff with a turn and a basic. Now, let me point out one thing. Double back, tap back, scuff up right here. She wrote it like she's doing a toe ball or a ball step, but she actually just did a touch step. And if you prefer to dance it that way, it's fine with me. For me, it's more comfortable to do a solid toe heel. Okay, so the whole thing, tunstall with a quarter turn near the end. Ready, go, double back, tap back, step up, toe heel, tap back, step, turn, and a base. Let's do those first three steps together. Kentucky loop, ready, go. Simone stomp, tunstall, quarter turn. Drag back and toe pulls. So think of the drag rock back, except we don't just start with a double step. We start right off with a drag rock step and repeat, drag rock step. And then there's a double step on the end. All right, weights on your right. Drag, rock, step twice. Ready? Go, drag, rock, step. On the double step, put it in front and put a little bit of a break or a flange style to that right foot and back. Because next, you're gonna do, whoops, losing my balance. Because next, you're gonna do the toe pulls. So that's slur the toe, step across, slur, step, slur, step, slur, step. When you're slurring forward, pull is another name that gets used a lot, and I will sometimes use that too. So those eight beats together are the drag, rock, and toe pulls, or drag, rock, and pulls. So weights on your right, you're facing the side, do that, ready, go, drag, rock, step, double steps, pull, step, pull, step, pull, step, pull, step. You end up into your left foot. And then with the right foot, across and kick. I used this in the easy intermediate dance that I taught last week and quickly reviewed this week, and I called it a cross break, B-R-A-K-E. But here I'll cue it cross and kick, that's on her cue sheet. Of course, some of the other names I adjusted slightly to things we're more familiar with. Anyway, but a cross and kick, right foot, it's four beats, double step across, step back and kick, start your turn, and then step, rock, step, as you do a full three-quarter turn to face the back. Okay, right foot, across and kick, three-quarter right. Ready, go, double step, and step with a kick, step, rock, step to face the back. So you end up facing the back after that, up, across and kick. And last week, we just did a double rock two here. And if you want to continue with that, you certainly can. But I'll teach you the alternative step that's an advanced step that we can use instead. It's called budding, at least that's how she cued it. Now, rather than teach it to you facing, I want to teach it to you facing away from you, so you're looking at my back, which means, tell you what, face this direction, because this whole section we're going to repeat. So when you repeat it, you're facing this way when you do the across and kick. So right foot, let's do that across and kick, double step across, step back with a kick, start your turn, and then step, rock, step, turning to face front. All right, do that one more time, just so you know, this is where we're gonna be. Right foot, cross and kick, ready? Go, double cross, and step and kick, step, rock, step, and then ba-ding, or double rock too, but we're gonna go over the ba-ding. Four counts. Start with a double step, and then it's a tap, step, tap. Okay, that's the first half. Left foot, double step, tap. One more time, and a one, and a two. Second half, if you know fastballs, an advanced sequence that we learned years ago, then this will be easy. Fastballs is the combination of going step, double, ball, ball, step. Step, double, ball, ball, step. And a one and two. Or, and a three and four. Okay, fastballs, so that's easy enough if you've done it. If you haven't, you're changing your weight to your left. It's probably onto the ball, even though I'm cueing it as a step. Double toe with the right, ball left, step flat. Left foot, fastballs, ready, go, and a one, and a two. Fastballs, ready, go, and a da, 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 da. Tell you what, let's do that whole ba-ding in place without the fanciness we're gonna add in a second. So ba-ding, starting with the left, double step, tap, step, double, toe, toe, step, or ball, ball, step. I'll try to say balls instead of toes here because it's a buck step. Okay, so ba-ding, ready, go, double step, tap, double, double step. Once more, but with the count, ba-ding, ready, go, and a one, and a two, and a three, and four. Now, what she did on those last two beats was really cool looking, so we're going to try and do that. First, two beats are the same, double step, tap, then ball double, do your double out to the side more, and then bring it behind for the toe, and then toe step, or ball step. So let's do those last two beats. Step double, ball step, okay? Got a little more to add, but do that much. Ball double, ball step. This time, ball double, as you do this, weight change to the right foot behind, lift the left foot up in front, you're crossing it. So it's like this. All right, leading with the heel, taps are pointed down, knees out to the side. So you have to twist your leg a little, kind of like the position you do when you do a cross brush. All right, this. So you're putting your weight on your right toe, or ball of the foot and back, and lifting that, and then bringing it down, and there's a weight change onto the left ball, and then your solid step. So slowly, let's see, weight's on the right to start this. Slowly, those last two beats. It's left, double toe, right behind but lift, ball, step. And again, ball, double, ball, step. I didn't do much of a lift there. I was concentrating on the weight changes. Once again, and then the count is, and a one, and a two, sort of. And a one, and a two. Okay, so if you can get that lift in front in there, it looks really cool. But it's not necessary. You don't have to do it. Okay, you can just do the double toe out, behind, side, step. All right, and that's a little bit fancier fastballs than a plain one. Okay, so let's do the whole ba-ding, left foot. Double, step, tap, step, double, ball, step. Ready, go, whoops, messed up. Ready, go, double, step, tap, da-da-da-da-da. 5, 6, 7, go, and a 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, ba-ding. It just takes practice. And I'll tell you, when I dance it in the dance, I probably won't have it solidified yet. I've been working on it and practicing it. But it's just like when you glue something together, okay? You glue the pieces together and they're staying, but the glue might not be permanently dry yet. So if you wiggle it around a little bit, put other stuff with it, sometimes it falls apart. So my glue isn't quite dried, but anyway, I'm gonna dance it, but I'm just warning you, when we do it to music, I may not get it right, okay? It's just a matter of additional practice. And same with you, if you don't have it quite yet, just continue to practice. Do it slowly, and then build up your speed. Okay, so let's combine those two steps, eighth to the side, and with the right foot, we're gonna do the across and kick. Turn 3/4 right into a ba-ding. Across and kick, 5, 6, 7, go, and then 1, 2, 3, and ba-ding, and 1, 2, and 3, 4. All right, one more time. Face the side, across and kick, 5, 6, 7, go, and 1, 2, 3, and ba-ding. And then, if you're facing the back, we should do it this direction once. Okay, so across and kick from here, right foot, and then the ba-ding facing the back. Let's do that. Right foot, ready, go, double cross, kick, step, rock, ba-ding. And then, you're still facing the back, we're gonna repeat the whole section. So the Kentucky Loop, the Simone Song, the Tunstall, quarter turn, here's the drag rock back, double step and pulls, across and kick, and ba-ding. Woo, part B. Okay, I'm gonna put the music on, we're gonna do A, which is just that one step, twice, and B, and that's most of it. But then we have one more new thing to do in part C as well. Alrighty. I've got to slow down a bit, quite a bit. It's not a fast song to begin with. So we're gonna wait for her to count, 2, 3, 4, and then left foot, start with that Shania turn, and we do it twice.
2, 3, 4.
Toe slide again. Kentucky loop. Simone stomp. Drag rock back and toe holds across and kick, face the back, ba-ding. So Kentucky loop, Simone stomp, tennis turn, drag rock back and holds across and kick, ba-ding. And let's go into the next section. Part C, no poles, no's in quotes, because that's where KT Tunstall is singing, no, 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 no. All right, so no pole, it's just a heel slur and a basic. And then a slur turn, so you're gonna step in front, slur, step on your left, and then a twist, double swivel right, left, lift the left foot. All right, so after your heel slur basic, right foot's free, step, slur, turn, step left, and swivel, double right, left, up, swivel or twist. Okay, so all together, heel slur, step, basic, slur, turn half, weight on your left, and twist. Lift the left. Make sure you lift the left. Okay, one more time. No pull and twist. Ready, go, and heel slur, step, and the basic, step, slur, step, double swivel, heel lift. And then last week we did a Utah basic here. Double step, double up, and a basic. You can continue that, or I'll turn around and show you what she calls a quickie. Quickie, four count step, and then after this, dancing the rest of it just like we did last week, okay? Quickie, left foot, double step, and then a double hop step. Those first two beats will sound and feel like a fake Canadian. Double step, double hop, touch, except instead of touching that right foot, you gotta put your weight on it, all right? So it's double step, double hop, step. Put your weight on that, let your weight shift. Once again, that's the first half of the quickie. Double step, double hop, step. Then for the second half to that step, for the second half, you're gonna go ball, ball, double, ball, step. Or think of that as a rock step if you want. That's the way I think of it. So those last two beats, left, right, double, left, right. And again, ready, go, ball, ball, double, rock step. Ball, ball, double, rock step. I'll probably cue it that way. Ready, go, ball, ball, double, rock step. So the count would be, and a three, and four. So put the double step, double hop, step in front. Double step, double hop, step, ball, ball, double, rock step. Okay, all together is called quickie. 5, 6, 7, go, and a 1, and 2, and a 3, and 4. And again, 5, 6, quickie, go, and 1, and 2, and a 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, go, and a 1, and 2, and a 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, go, and a 1, and 2, and a 3, and 4. All right, quickie. I'm still getting used to it myself, so I might goof up later. I have to say that just in case, because it's probably gonna happen. Okay, and then after the quickie, we have two fake Canadians. And I did have those in the dance last week. So we have the no pulls and twist so that you face the back. And we do the quickie and two fake Canadians. Okay, so let's do those first three steps, the no pulls and twist. The quickie and the fake Canadians. No, you'll be doing the quickie and fake Canadians facing the back. No pulls and twist. Heel slur, basic. Slur turn, twist. Quickie, double step, double, hop step, double, rock step. Two fake Canadians, sorry. And then we're gonna repeat, no pulls and twist, heel slur, basic, slur turn, twist, and then quickie, so double step, double hop step, da 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 da, and go ahead and do the fake Canadians. The first two times we do this section, you don't repeat the fake Canadians, we'll just do two double steps, or two runs. But the last time, in the back of my card, near the end of the dance, we will. So let's go ahead and practice it that way, so that we can practice this step a little bit more, okay? So, part C2, this is where it repeats the same way. No pulls and twist, ready? Go, and heel, slur, step, basic. Slur, turn, twist, quickie, double, double, hop, step. Fake Canadians, no pulls. Pull, slur, turn, twist, quickie. Fake Canadians. All right, I think we should do it one more time. No pulls and twist. 5, 6, 7, go. Heel, slur, step. Slur, turn, quickie. Fake Canadians. And again, no pulls. Slur, turn, and twist. Quickie. Fake Canadians. Whew. All right. I'm going to put it on near the end of the dance where we do just that much with music. Okay, so this is right near the end. We're going to practice it that way. And then I'll go back to part C1 and we'll practice it where we don't repeat the Canadian fake Canadians at the end. We'll just do two runs. Okay, but for now, we're gonna repeat it the same way. Here we go. No pulls and twists. Ready, go.
No, 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 no.
Turn and twist. I was kind of sloppy. I hope you did better than I did. Now I'm gonna go back to the first time we do C. So we do the no pulls and twist, the quickie, the fake Canadians, repeat, no pulls and twist, quickie, but then just two double steps. I'll cue it as two runs. All right, so the first time we do C, here we go. 5, 6, 7, heel slur, slow turn, and twist. Now, Shania, turn. Blue, almost didn't make it. All the way around. Alrighty, I was pretty shaky there. But anyway, back it up and try it again, if you were to. And then I'm gonna move on, since this is a kind of a review. Okay, so that's part C. We do A2, which is that Shania turn just once. And then you repeat B and C, exactly the way we did them. And then A, one, which means you do the Shania turn twice, which is the easier way. And then C2, which is the no pulls, the quickie, the fake Canadians, repeat exactly the same. No pulls, quickie, fake Canadians. And then we get to the ending. Let's do the ending. Stuff we've done, mostly. Left foot lead is kind of like part B. One Kentucky loop, Simone stomp, tongue stole, turn a quarter, drag back in toe pulls. Now, whoops, one more. You have to end up on your left. Right foot, across and kick, but instead of going three quarters, we're gonna turn just a quarter to face front. Double step, 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 rock, step. And then we have about three beats. I think it's actually a little less, but we're gonna do a three count ba-ding. Three count ba-ding or short ba-ding. So we're just gonna do double step, tap, step, immediately, no pause there. So, and a one, and a two, and. I think that's the way I count it. That's the way it comes out for me. So once again, short ba-ding. Let's do the across and kick. Right foot, meet your right foot. Quarter turn right, and the short ba-ding. Ready, go. Step, kick, step, rock, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And that will end it. All right, let's do the whole thing. I'm gonna do my best, but I can't guarantee I'll do everything perfectly right. All right, so this is Black Horse and the Cherry Tree, danced by Mrs. Shinoski of Missouri, and music by KT Tunstall. We are gonna wait through her count of 2, 3, 4. Start with the left foot with a Shania turn, and you'll be turning half to the right and then repeating it. Okay, here we go. It's not quite full speed. Because of the new advanced steps, I have to slow down just a hair or two. Left foot ready for Shania turn.
2, 3, 4.
Do it again. Kentucky move. Simone stomp. Drag rock and pull. Across and kick. Three quarters, face back. Pudding. Kentucky loop. Simone stomp. Tunstall. Turn a quarter. Drag rock and pull. Across and kick. Face front. Pudding. No pull, heel swerve, drift and twist, tricky, and Canadian, no pulls and twist, turn, twist, tricky, run to Shania turn, go all the way around, Kentucky loop, Simone stomp, Tunstall. Turn a quarter left, drag rock and pull, across and kick, face back, ba-ding, Kentucky loop, Simone stomp, Tunstall, drag rock and pull, across and kick, ba-ding. No pulls. Turn it. Quickie. Stay Canadian. No pulls. Turn and twist. Quickie. Run to Shania turn. Gonna do twice. No pulls. Twist, creaky, take Canadians, no pulls, twist, creaky, take Canadians, Kentucky loop, slow stomps, tunstall, turn a corner, drag rock pull. Cross and kick, face front, and it's short of me. Well, it's far from perfect, but I danced most of it, and I hope you got through it okay. That is Black Horse and the Cherry Tree by Missy Shinoski. And for the last dance today, I'm going to cue Troublemaker. Dances by Kelly Ramirez, music by Ollie Mers. And this was a fun one with mostly familiar steps. We started off with a layover. Part C has a Chuck Kentucky plus a Rock Kentucky. Let's do that once. A little step, kick, slide, kick, step, rock, step for the Chuck Kentucky. But then for the Rock Kentucky, do another rock step, turn back, chug across, drag step, rock step. All right, so put those two together. On part D, which we do much later in the dance, is a clog over loop D, loop two, one, two, three, loop step, double step, loop step, and basic. That leaves your right foot free, and we do a Joey rocker. So you're going to do one Joey with the right, and then rock step twice as you move forward, and basic. Actually, forward towards the corner. All right, so right foot, Joey rocker. Ready, go, Joey. rock twice, and a basic, and then you do the clog over loop to the right, loop again, and a basic, Joey rocker, do a Joey, rock twice, and a basic, and then we have four Russian turns. The ending is one stomp. All right, so let's dance it. This is Troublemaker. Wait 16. I hear four beats and then 12. But I'll let you know when we're about to start. We start with a layover. Left foot.
You're a troublemaker, troublemaker.
5, 6, 7, layover.
You had me up again from the minute you
Lays under twice. And a triple. Right foot layover. Two flea flickers. And triple. Twisty bounce. Charleston once. And a double rock two. Chuck Kentucky. Rock Kentucky. And a triple. Face the back. Four crazy eggs. Rock Kentucky, triple face front, and crazy leg, four, leg over again, knee flicker twice, a triple, lay over right the lead, knee flicker twice, and a triple, whoops. Chuck Kentucky, Rock Kentucky, triple go 3/4, crazy legs 4, we're going to do it again, Chuck Kentucky here, we'll make a box, Rock Kentucky, triple roll right, 3/4, face the back, crazy legs, Chuck Kentucky, Rock Kentucky, triple roll, crazy legs, you face to the side, one more time, Chuck Kentucky, Rock Kentucky, triple roll face front, and crazy legs, quad over loop two, Joey rocker, Joey, rock two, and a basic, to the right, quad over loop two, Joey rocker, rock twice, and a basic, Russian turn, four times. One more. Chuck Kentucky. Rock Kentucky. Triple 3/4 again. Crazy legs. Chuck Kentucky. Rock Kentucky. Triple roll 3/4. Face the back. Crazy legs. Chuck Kentucky. Rock Kentucky. Triple 3/4. Face the side. Crazy legs. One more time. Chuck Kentucky. Rock Kentucky, triple roll, and crazy legs. One stomp to end it.
Woo!
That's Troublemaker. Alrighty, thank you for dancing with me this week. I hope you enjoyed it and maybe learned something. And as always, let me know if there's something you'd like me to teach in these videos. I'll see you next time.